The White House has rolled out the red carpet for Scott and Jenny Morrison, with Donald Trump putting on a special show for our Prime Minister. It was all business on the front lawn, but inside the Oval Office, the President went rogue, forcing Mr. Morrison to grin and bear witness to the Trump presidency. Nine's political editor Chris Yuleman begins our coverage.
The pomp, pageantry and unpredictability that is the Trump White House.
You're a joke. Okay, what else?
America's president gifted Scott and Jenny Morrison the rare honour of being greeted as his state's guests. With all the military grandeur the stars and stripes can muster. The review of troops and formal welcome followed a well-rehearsed script.
We vow to carry on the righteous legacy of our exceptional alliance.
Australians and Americans understand each other like few other peoples.
But order gave way to chaos in the Oval Office.
It's just another political hack job.
As over half an hour, Scott Morrison was a bit player in the Donald Trump hyper-reality show.
We're going to Mars. Scott has very strong opinions on China. The fake news doesn't look into things like that. It's a disgrace.
The Prime Minister watched as the President danced through a minefield of questions, including the chance of conflict with Iran, which has been considered.
That's the easiest thing I could do. It's so easy.
But seems unlikely.
I think restraint is a good thing.
Australia has committed a ship to patrol waterways in the Persian Gulf and does not want to be drawn into another Middle Eastern conflict, but won't say no.
We always listened to whatever requests are made.
Just hours later, the US Defence Secretary announced some troops would be dispatched to Saudi Arabia.
We think for now that would be sufficient, but that doesn't mean there could be additional deployments.
But there is an even more sensitive topic for Australia.
Is it just a trade issue for you, or do you see China as a strategic threat to the United States?
Obviously, China is a threat to the world, in a sense, because they're building a military faster than anybody. And frankly, they're using U.S. money.
That is a conversation the Prime Minister would rather not indulge.
We have a great relationship with China. China's growth has been great for Australia.
There was good news. Australia will join NASA in its plans for exploring space.
So we'll be doing the moon, but we'll really be doing Mars.
And an invitation has been extended for the President to visit Australia.
We'll have to see what the schedule is, but I would love to do it.
In true Trump style, the President tried to best George W. Bush, who once dubbed John Howard the Man of Steel.
He's a man of titanium. Believe me, I have to deal with this guy.
Scott Morrison will have to be made of stern stuff to cope with a president apparently coated in Teflon.
Well, Nine's political editor Chris Yuleman and US correspondent Charles Croucher are in Washington tonight for us. Chris, a unique experience for Scott Morrison, but then again, he's working with a unique character.
Well, Mark, this American president is a unique experience for all of us, and that press conference in the Oval Office embodied all the problems that world leaders do have in dealing with Donald Trump, and that is, you can't be certain what he's going to do or what he's going to say, and when he speaks, you can't be certain of his words because he often contradicts himself within hours, and that presents a problem for Australia right at a time when we're trying to deal with another difficult superpower in China. We need America to be rock solid, but Charles, I think that Scott Morrison is doing as well as can be expected.
Yeah, I spoke to one former ambassador today who said exactly that. This is both an opportunity and also a challenge for Scott Morrison because there are other governments around the world that have tried and failed with the old methods of diplomacy, those formal structured one-on-ones or even diplomatic back channels. With Donald Trump, it seems you might get further on the golf course at one of his resorts or even had a dinner under the stars at Washington's most famous address.
Under the Washington sky, tables decorated in green and gold for a night of black and white. Just the second state dinner of the administration, the first to be al fresco, a reflection of Australia's ability to negotiate with America under Donald Trump.
Our two countries were born out of a vast wilderness, settled by the adventurers and pioneers whose fierce self-reliance shaped our destiny.
The night began with a smile and a laugh, Mrs. Morrison wearing Australian designer Carla Zampatti. Mrs. Trump, a J. Mendel gown.
Australia will never be accused of indifference in our friendship to the United States. And tonight, Mr. President, we are reminded that the United States feels the same way, especially under your leadership.
In a town where money talks, the Australian delegation included Gina Rinehart, Twiggy Forrest, Lachlan and Sarah Murdoch, Joe Hockey, and the golfer that's turned diplomat, Greg Norman.
Did you play golf with Trump this week?
No, not this week. I haven't before that.
With the military band lining the White House rooftop and walkway, the guests enjoyed a music extravaganza. Before sitting down to dinner, designed by the First Lady, ravioli, Dover sole, and apple pie. The Trumps had gifts for the Morrisons, including a Tiffany bowl and jewellery box, a model of American warship the USS Canberra, a framed map of the Battle of the Coral Sea, and a hand-bound leather album.
I'd like to raise a glass to very special people and a very, very special country.
To the people of these United States, to the President and his magnificent First Lady, and may God bless America.
When US Marines first landed in Melbourne after the horrors of war in the Pacific, Australian bands played Waltzing Matilda. It was a sight and sound so welcome, the Marines made it one of their anthems. And tonight, 76 years on, they played it once more here in Washington.
In Washington, D.C., Charles Crouch, 9 News.
Hi, YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great 9 videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.